The dot notation is very useful when we want to access a explicit property of an object. So in this particular case, for example, we want to access the total score of a player. So we can do player, which is this object, dot score, which points to this object, dot total. Obviously, we can access the average by simply replacing total with average, and it will display 67. That's fine. But what happens if we want to dynamically access either the average or the total? Of course, we can have two functions, right? Get average score will return the average, and get total score that will return the total. But in JavaScript, we can dynamically access one property or another one using square bracket notation. So what that means? So we have the object, and then we can have another property, which is the value we want to access. So in this particular case, our function getScore has two arguments. First of all, the player, and then as the second argument, we get the total, right? So that total, this is the property that we want to access. So then, how do we access property? Can we do that? No, that wouldn't work. And the reason why this wouldn't work is because it returns undefined. We don't have any property explicitly named as prop, right? So this is not correct. However, technically speaking, we can do that. We can replace the dot notation with a square bracket notation. So at the end of the day, player.score square bracket prop will be replaced by player.score dot total. So that will display 875, correct. And now if we change total with average, that will display 67, right? So again, so this is the same as doing that. So that will display 875, that will display 67, and then we can probably easily determine that in reality that string can be replaced by a dynamic variable.